Let me show you a different approach to figure out the value of equity in the last example. Recall that we computed the value of equity by first calculating the cash flows that equity holders receive after all the payments to debt holders have been taken into account. This alternative approach starts by first computing the value of the assets of the firm, not the value of equity. That is, we first compute the value of the cash flows that the assets of the firm generate. These are cash flows purely from operations, and we do not subtract any payment to any of the capital providers of the firm, either equity or debt holders. The name these cash flows receive is free cash flows to the firm, or simply free cash flows. In our next module, we will define this concept formally. These cash flows are shown here. They are the same as in our first version of this example, or $10,000 per year. The present value of these cash flows is $100,000. As I said, this $100,000 is the value of the assets of the firm. This value belongs to both equity and debt holders. But we know that debt holders own $15,000 of these $100,000, leaving $85,000 of value to equity holders. Note that we have obtained the same answer as with the cash flows to equity method. Let me illustrate this method by using the market value balance sheet. By discounting the free cash flows, we obtain the value of the assets of the firm. We place this $100,000 on the left side of the balance sheet. On the right-hand side of the balance sheet, we place the value of debt of $15,000. Since the market value balance sheet needs to balance, the value of equity must be $85,000. This method to value a firm or its equity by discounting the free cash flows is called the firm discounted cash flow model, or sometimes enterprise discounted cash flow model. People also abbreviate discount cash flows as simply DCF. In this course, we will be focusing on this method.